Okay students, now let us learn how a yarn is converted into fabric. Till now we have understood how a fibers will be obtained from the plants and the fiber which is obtained from the plant, how it is converted into yarn we learned, right? By spinning we will be converting the cotton fibers, especially we are talking. So the cotton fibers will be converted into fiber, cotton fibers to yarn by spinning. Now let us learn how this yarn which is obtained from spinning is used to prepare a fabric. So in the first class itself we have understood, so from fibers yarn will be produced, from yarn fabric will be produced. So fibers we have discussed, yarn we have discussed, next left with the yarn to fabric, a fabric, right? So mainly in conversion of yarn into fabric there are many different methods, but mainly two methods are widely used. Okay, so these methods are weaving and knitting. So there are many different methods, other methods are there, but well known and popularized methods are weaving and knitting. So weaving, see here K is silent, you should not say knitting. Okay, it is knitting. Okay, K is silent. Okay, so weaving and knitting, these are the two main methods which are used for conversion of yarn into fabric. Okay, so how a weaving will be done, how a knitting will be done, how a weaving is different from a knitting. Okay, so let's go with the activity. So first let us learn about weaving. So to understand how a weaving will be done, okay, so to do that let's take a piece of paper. So students, if you have a colored paper it is well, okay, but I don't have at present, I don't have any colored paper, so I have taken one paper. Just make it into two equal halves. Okay, and now again fold it and again cut it. Okay, again just you need to get some stripes. Okay, so to get stripes we are going to cut it like this. So make sure that everything should be equal. Why it should be equal? Because if it is uneven the fabric will not come in a proper way. So if it is at an even proportion then the fabric will be of good quality. Okay, so if you have an uneven length, no, so then the fabric somewhere you will be having gaps, somewhere you will be having all the fibers will be, all the yarn will come at one particular place, so it won't look good. So for that okay, so now we have stripes like this. So students, here what you need to do, so here these are plain, I'm just taking two, you can take as many you want. So two into two I need, so I have taken two plain and two striped one. Okay, so to just differentiate, so two I kept like this and two I need to keep like this. So how I need to keep, so first like this and next, so first I kept white one, then upon that I have kept the striped one, then upon striped one I will be keeping like this. So like this you need to do, one up and one down. Okay, so I will show you still more if you want. Yes, once if I take upside, next I need to take downside. So this is how it looks. See here. Yes, I'm done with it. Okay, you can do more colorful. Yes. So this is how it looks. So you can do more beautifully than me. Okay, you can use a multi colors. Okay, so you can use a different colored each paper with each stripe with each color you can do, or you can take two different alternative colors so that you can prepare a fabric and just show me in a comment box so that even I will feel more better, happier, right? So yes. Okay, so you understood, right, how a knitting is being done here. Okay, so knitting, it is a process where we have used two strands, right? One strand in a horizontal way and the other strand in a vertical way we have used, right? Vertical and horizontal, right? So here two strands are used to prepare a fabric, right? So this method we call as weaving. So what is a weaving? The process of arranging two sets of yarn together to make a fabric is called as weaving. So here two strands will be used, where one will be in a vertical direction and the other one is a horizontal direction, and together it is being waved. Okay, so this process of weaving is whatever we have done. No, so we have used a paper which is a very short piece, right? But okay, so for preparation of fabric we are going to use very long yarns. Okay, so the yarns are very long, and by using that a fabric will be prepared. So how this fabric will be prepared? Okay, so the fabric, whatever the weaving which is done, no, so this weaving of fabric is done generally by with the help of looms. Okay, looms are used for preparation of fabric. Either these looms might be operated by hands, means hand operated looms will be there, or even power operated looms will be there. So either power operated looms or hand operated looms are used for weaving a fabric. Understood? So this is how a waved fabric will looks like. Okay, and coming to the next method, that is knitting. So in knitting, what is the difference that we can see in the knitting? So in weaving we will be using two strands. In knitting we will be using single strand of yarn. A single strand of yarn is used to make a piece of fabric here. So this is how a knitting is different from the weaving. Okay, so when you see here, this knitting is done by hands directly, or even it is used, is also done with the help of the machines also. So here like this, two needles will be there. Using the two needles this knitting will be done. Okay, so you can see this knitting is using knitting. Yes, in home you might have seen preparation of carrier bags or sweaters, socks, all these being done. Okay, so this is how a knitting works here. So whenever, if you have observed, okay, you might have taken your socks. Okay, if a thread comes out from your socks, if you pull that thread, okay, you might have seen entire socks will be disappeared into yarn. Okay, okay, why? Because the socks fabric is formed by using the knitting. Because of that, yes, what we can see that, yes, as the entire fabric is done with a single thread, okay, which we, if we pull a thread from the socks, entire socks will be converted into yarn here. Okay, so this is about the conversion of yarn into fabric by using the two different methods. One is weaving and the other method is knitting. So this is about today's class, students. Thank you.